Hi, and welcome to this review of fractions and mixed numbers. Before we dive in, let's review the basic parts of a fraction. Remember, a fraction simply represents a part of a whole. It has a numerator and a denominator, which tells us what the part is and what the whole is. Let's look at the fraction 3/4 as an example. We can see that the 3 is our numerator and the 4 is our denominator. So the fraction 3/4 is really saying 3 parts out of 4 parts total. It can also be helpful to visualize 3/4 as simply 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4. It is very important to remember that a denominator of 4 does not represent the value of 4. A denominator of 4 represents the value of 1 that is divided up into 4 equal parts, or fourths. The type of fraction we're working with here represents a value less than 1 whole. 3/4 is not quite 1. If we had 4/4, that would be equivalent to 1. But we only have 3 out of 4 parts. We see and use fractions that are less than 1 all the time in our daily lives, whether it's for things like recipes or keeping track of time. Recipes often call for amounts such as 1/2 teaspoon of salt. And we often keep track of time in terms of quarter hours, like a quarter past 3 for 3:15. Though we observe this type of fraction very frequently in our daily lives, it is not the only type of fraction. Consider the following scenario. You're ordering pizza for a big celebration. There will be lots of hungry guests at this celebration, so you order 3 pizzas. Each pizza is cut into 6 slices. This means that each pizza has 6 equal parts, and as a fraction, 6 would be considered our whole, or our denominator. If your first guest eats 2 slices, we would represent this as the fraction 2/6. 2 parts out of 6 parts total. But what if that first guest was really hungry and grabbed 7 slices? Again, each pizza was cut into 6 equal slices, so 6 remains as our whole, or denominator. But this time our part is 7. In this scenario, our numerator is larger than our denominator, 7 over 6. Fractions with a numerator larger than their denominator are referred to as improper fractions. Essentially, improper fractions equal a value that is more than 1. 1 whole pizza would be represented by 6 over 6, or 6/6. 7 over 6 represents 7/6, which is more than 1 pizza. This could be visualized as 1 over 6 plus 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 1 over 6 equals 7 over 6. It can also be written in another form called a mixed number. An improper fraction and a mixed number will represent the same amount, but simply be written in a different form. For example, the improper fraction 7 over 6 could also be written as the mixed number 1 1/6. Mixed numbers and improper fractions share the same amount, but as a mixed number, the parts are collected and consolidated into as many groups of one whole as possible. For example, 4 over 4 would be grouped together as 1. 7 over 7 would also be grouped together as 1. Any value where the numerator is equivalent to the denominator would be expressed simply as 1. In our pizza example, the guest took 7 slices from a group of pizzas that were sliced into 6ths. We said this could be represented as the improper fraction 7 over 6, or visualized as 1 over 6 plus 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 1 over 6. As a mixed number, we would group 6 of these 6ths in order to form 6 over 6, or 1 whole. By grouping 6 over 6 together, we can see that 1 over 6 is left over. We would write our mixed number as 1 1/6. Let's try a few more examples. Let's write the following improper fractions as mixed numbers. 4/3 can be visualized as 1 over 3 plus 1 over 3 plus 1 over 3 plus 1 over 3. We know that 3 over 3 is equal to 1. So let's group 3 of these thirds together. We are now left with 1 1/3 as our mixed number. 3/2 can be visualized as 1/2 plus 1/2 plus 1/2. We then know that 2/2, 2 over 2, makes 1 whole. and we're left with 1/2 left over. So 3/2 as a mixed number is 1 1/2. Let's try one more example. 7/4. 7/4 is the same as 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4 plus 1/4. Now we know that 4/4 are grouped as one whole. So these 4/4 pulled over to equal 1, and we're left with 1 2 3/4. 7/4 written as a mixed number is 1 3/4. This process will take place in reverse in order to convert between a mixed number to an improper fraction. For example, if we started with a mixed number 1 3/4 and we wanted to convert it to an equivalent improper fraction, we would take a look at the whole number. In this case, it is 1. This whole number is really representing the denominator that's in the fraction. In this case, it's 4, so the 1 is equal to 4 over 4. When we combine these 4/4 with the 3/4, we end up with 7/4 total, or 7 over 4. That's all there is to it. I hope that this video was helpful. Thanks for watching, and happy studying.